It's roses. Stay with us next on Gardeners Hotline. Welcome to Gardeners Hotline. I'm your host, Karen Stauderman, a University of Florida Horticulture Extension agent. Roses are one of the most popular flowering shrubs in Florida and the U.S. They're beautiful and often fragrant flowers have been growing in gardens for centuries as vines, shrubs, ground covers, and container plants. Roses are native to the United States and date back many years. A rose fossil was found in Colorado and was estimated to be 35 million years old. Did you know that George Washington was our first U.S. rose breeder? Well, it's no wonder that the rose is the official national floral emblem of the United States. We're lucky in Florida. Roses can grow and flower 9 months of the year in North Florida and year-round the rest of Florida. Today's program will answer your questions about growing roses. Our guest is a familiar face to the program. He's Mark Nelson, owner of Nelson's Roses in Apopka, Florida. Welcome to the program today, Mark.
Thank you, Karen. Thank you very much. Always a pleasure to be here.
Thank you, Mark. I'm so excited to have you here, and I know all of our viewers at home want to learn more about roses. So let's invite them to the program by calling in with this number. It's 1-800-901-9238. Well, let's get started. What's happened since the last time you've been here? It's been a while.
Oh, yeah. Well, there's just lots of things happening in the rose world. Always new colors, always new varieties, always new things coming about. Roses have been around for a long time, but the hybridizers, the people that produce the colors and the new varieties of roses, they always seem to come up with more.
Wow. Well, I know we took the camera out there to your guys' nursery, and we got some great footage. So let's take a look at that and see what's going on at your farm, and tell us what's going on.
Hey, let's do that.
All right. Well, first of all, tell me, how many people work at the farm?
Oh, probably 20.
20?
20, okay. 20 people. We have 10 acres of greenhouse, and we have an outdoor, probably about 3 acres outdoors, where we do a lot of roses.
How many different varieties do you have outside?
200.
Wow, 200 different varieties?
Yes, 200 different varieties.
Wow.
And they go from being young ones, newly potted. We always put them in blue pots. And
why is that?
It started out sort of, years ago we grew them in green cans.
Okay.
And that was sort of our trademark. And we decided we needed to come up with a different trademark when the plastic pots came out.
Oh.
And so we decided on a color scheme, and it was no as fancy as here's a Folgers coffee cup, here's a blue Maxwell House. And we said, well, the blue one looks a little better than the red. So that's the story of Nelson's blue pots.
So every time we see a blue pot of this color, we know it's from Nelson's.
It's from Nelson's.
Wow, and they're beautiful selections that you have there.
All of our roses are grafted on Rosa Fortuniana rootstock. That's a little bit of the rootstock right there. It blooms once a year, but it grows all the time, and it loves the heat of Florida's summer. So it's really heat-resistant is what it really is. The Fortuniana, most varieties, when you put them on it, do a lot better.
So again, they don't come from seed. That is the bottom, and this is the top.
That's the bottom, and that's the top.
Wow, you can do so many things with them.
Yes, you can do trees, you can do trellises, you can do really tall trees for a customer that likes like 6 foot trees.
Wow.
Most of the trees are about 4 feet tall, so those are extra tall because we have a customer that loves that.
Now, do you sell by far more shrubs or trees or vines? What do you sell the most of?
I would say we probably sell more floribundas. Really, than anything, just because they tend to have more color on them.
And they're shrubs?
And they're shrubs.
Okay. You have quite a bit now spaced out. Are they spaced out according to different varieties?
Yes, they're spaced out according to different varieties, and we grow them outside until we bring them in to the winter. We will bring them in the winter months. We'll bring them into 2 acres of glasshouse in the winter so that we always make Valentine's Day.
Well, when is winter in Florida for you?
Winter's usually, you know, we usually have them in there by December 1st.
Okay. And then when do you pull them out?
When it starts getting hot. When we can get away with it. So we'll pull them out right about after Easter.
Wow, that's quite a bit.
You know, we love to have a cool Easter, but usually it's fairly hot right after Easter these days.
Yeah. Now, tell me a little bit about what's inside the greenhouses. You have outside and inside. What keeps them in the greenhouse?
We leave them in the greenhouse just so they'll bloom, just so they'll bloom on schedule and on time. And in the past, we've had freezes, and the freezes really don't hurt the roses, but they will hurt the blooms. You know, the blooms themselves will freeze, and so you don't have that color.
I see. Now, if they're in the greenhouse, is the color truer or does it fade out?
No, it fades out, really. Inside. We see these roses inside, and we just move these in, so they're not really fading yet. But
what square feet is that, each greenhouse?
44,000 square feet.
Wow.
So there's a lot of roses there, a lot of different varieties.
How many plants is that?
There's about 15,000 inside.
Okay, and then still 200 different varieties?
Yes, yes.
Wow. Okay, which one's this one? What's that called?
That is actually Grace de Monaco.
Wow. Oh, Mark, they're stunning.
Yeah, they do really well inside, and they love it inside, especially if it's a little bit cool. These are the babies.
How old are they?
They're probably 3 months old right there, and they'll be ready in late spring for Mother's Day.
Okay. And how much bigger will they get, or is it just a matter of they're setting blocks?
It's just how much time it takes them to get big and how much time it takes them to get full. You can see the little drip irrigation. Each pot is drip irrigated. We fertilize them and water them at the same time.
All of the varieties at the same time?
Yes.
Okay, but they clearly don't bloom at the same time.
No, they don't bloom at the same... No, they really bloom about every 4 to 5 weeks.
Okay.
I mean, if we cut them all back and they didn't have any color on them at all, they'd bloom again in 4 or 5 weeks.
And I know they're heavy feeders, so how often do you fertilize these?
Every day.
Liquid fertilizer. Wow.
Yeah. So they get a lot of fertilizer, but we ask them to grow quite a bit.
Right. So when we get a Nelson's roses and put it in our landscape, do you have them do a rigorous feeding right after they get in, or allow them to?
Well, not really. We try and tell people that what we've done, they do have Osmocote in them, so they do have a slow release fertilizer already in the pot.
Okay.
And so that's, in addition, the liquid feed we give them is in addition to that.
Oh, okay.
So they're kind of getting a, you know, extra fertilizer from us so that they bloom and look like they do.
Well, we already have a caller on the line. We have Jewel from Daytona. Hi, Jewel. What's your question for Mark Nelson today?
What is the average lifespan of a rose? How long can they live? And is there a way that you can make them live longer?
Yeah, the average lifespan for a rose in Florida is probably 5 to 15 years.
Okay, that's the shrub itself.
Yes, that's okay. The rose. Yeah, the rose will last that long.
Well, why so short? Because some of them can live for 100 or 1,000 years in Germany.
Well, in Florida, we're kind of unique. The roses never go to sleep.
Okay.
They don't really rest.
So
the roses in Germany get the rest from September through April, and the roses here grow all year round. So
okay.
So that rose might look like it's 5 years old, but comparatively speaking to a rose up in a northern climate, it's pretty old.
So it's okay to switch them out then. We kind of expect to have
okay to switch them out, and it's okay to try new colors. And no matter what I say about roses, what I know works is people love a particular color. They love a particular smell, and We're open to the public every Saturday, so we kind of, we speak to the people that buy the roses all the time. We don't just sell them commercially to a garden center. We actually can speak to the customers also.
I'm going to put you on the spot, though. What's the most popular color?
Red.
Red?
Red.
Wow.
Red.
Okay, and what's the most popular scent that it tends toward?
Like a traditional, what you'd say rose water smells like.
Okay.
Like a Mr. Lincoln smells like this, Chrysler Imperial smells like this, Angel Face smells like this, the very, very fragrant rose. McCartney smells like this. Now, the nice thing about McCartney is not only does it smell, which we smelled it earlier, uh-huh. It's very fragrant.
Is that this one?
Yes, that's this one.
This is McCartney.
Yes. Not only is it fragrant, but it's an easy-to-grow variety.
And you told me this was named after Paul McCartney.
Yes. McCartney picked that out, and they called it the McCartney Rose.
Wow, it's stunning. What a good selection.
Smells good.
Oh, it does. It's really intense. That's a beautiful-smelling rose. Now, can most of us in Florida grow this, or is this a hard-to-grow one?
No, that's an easy one. That's one of those that you just stick in the ground and look out, because it's a real grower.
Wow. Take a look at this gorgeous one. Now, and while we start with that one, we got a call from Cheryl. Cheryl, what's your question for Mark today?
Hello?
Hi, Cheryl. Go ahead with your question.
Okay. I love the thornless roses. In particular, I like red roses. And I have not been able to find an old one that used to be available called Old Smoothie. It's a hybrid tea. Rose, I was wondering what thornless varieties you might suggest.
Well,
the
only thing that we thornless varieties came out about 5 years ago, and they pushed them pretty hard, and they didn't sell very well. And you know, we haven't gotten any from any of the hybridizers. We haven't really received any new varieties from them, and unfortunately, like a lot of varieties, I mean, granted, we grow 200 now, but we've probably discarded or had to discontinue 300 or 400 varieties.
Wow.
That's just, I mean in 40 years of growing roses, you kind of go through different varieties.
And fads?
Different fads,
wow.
Different colors, yes.
Wow.
Very much so.
Now, tell me a little bit about this one. This one is spectacular as well.
That's probably the king of all varieties. That's an All-American winner in 1977 called Double Delight.
Double Delight, and it still holds up with this beauty. I love the blush.
Double Delight is one of a kind. Smells really strong and is beautiful. Anytime somebody sees this rose, they pretty much purchase it.
Wow, it's gorgeous.
Some roses I have to sell people on.
Okay, which ones?
Normally it's the easy care ones that I have to say, okay, by golly, you just need to do this one because this is really easy
to
grow.
Speaking of that one, what's the beginner rose? What would be good for the person who wants to start their first rose garden in Florida?
In Florida, you would start with Louis Philippe.
Okay, now which one's Louis Philippe?
Louis Philippe's not here, but Louis Philippe looks just like this Mother's Day. Mother's Day looks a lot like Louis Philippe.
All right, but this is a small rose. What if we want to try something bigger?
You want to try something bigger, you might try McCartney. Like I said, McCartney is pretty hard to beat when it comes to vigorous and toughness. And
how tall does it get?
Bushy.
Right.
It's one of those that grows real big.
We've got Cody from New Smyrna Beach. Hi, Cody. Welcome to the program. What's your question?
I was wondering how big some of the blooms can get on different roses.
Good question.
That's a great question. Pretty much.
That's a big one over there.
Yeah, that's probably the biggest one, by far.
Which one?
Ladybird.
And that's the one that looks like a Florida gator color.
Yeah, it does. It
kind of
looks like
favorite.
A Florida gator. If we could ever find a blue rose to go next to it, we'd have it beat. But they keep telling us they're going to do a blue rose, but they just can't do it.
Well, your shirt kind of matches our Florida gator blue colors.
That's
now,
right.
Hey, go Gators on that one. Isn't that stunning?
There we go.
Is this one hard to grow?
No,
okay,
it's not.
How big do some of these roses get?
They get bigger when it gets cooler. Doesn't have anything to do with fertilizer, has nothing to do with what we're feeding them or looking at them like. It's really as it gets cooler, your roses get get bigger.
How cool? Does it have to get, like, freezing weather?
No. In the 60s, in the 50s. As long as it's not 90 degrees night and it's raining, roses like it.
So it's 60s during the day or 60s at night temperatures?
60s at night.
Okay.
Yeah. That's why you see these big roses in California.
Yes.
And Oregon and Washington out west because they have cool nights.
Right.
We don't have that here.
Yeah, but they can't bloom theirs year-round like we can.
No, they can't.
Now, Mark, I know you're going to demonstrate how we should make a flower arrangement using roses. Now, you'd think it'd be easy and common, but there is a trick to it, so I want you to show the viewers how we do that and tell us all your tricks.
Yeah, well, what we kind of do, we can kind of talk about pruning sort of while we do this.
Okay.
So when you have a vase, you want to get your rose, and you go out to your bush, and you know your bush might be up here head high, but first of all, you want to have it where you put it in your vase.
From the bottom of your vase to the top.
Yeah, just sort of however tall you want to come out of the vase.
Some people,
you know, I don't really like that much, so you just do that. Put them together. These are all sort of sized up.
So you pre-cut these?
Yeah, I CGI'd this.
Don't you add water first before you
add water.
Okay.
You'd add some water. But that's a quick how-to on how you would do a vase of roses.
And you don't take the leaves off the bottom?
Yes, I do. I would take them up to where
Great demonstration, Mark.
Great demonstration. Great demonstration. And so when you're pruning your roses, you probably would prune them to our waist level any time of the year. And I would always tell people to prune your roses. And don't necessarily do what you would do up north when you're familiar with cutting them back real far. And if you never do that, if you always prune your roses back to your waist, you'll be happy with them. Because roses down here, what blooms roses is pruning them.
So we want to make sure they come up to the waist before we prune them to
Yes.
Now, if you take your rose and take the thorns off of it and then stick it in the flower arrangement, is that causing too much damage to it? I know some people take the thorns off. Is that necessary?
It's not that. It's just some usually the stems are not rigid enough.
Okay.
Because of our hot weather to dethorn them.
All
with
right.
with a little, I've tried dethorning them. I've tried doing everything. When we did the Disney Flower Festival, we handed out roses and little bitty vases.
Yes.
And so we tried to dethorn them.
It didn't work.
It was a nightmare. So
we've got Barbara that has a question burning to answer you. Hi, Barbara. Welcome to the program. What's your question?
Hi. I had just tuned in when you were talking about the McCarthy Rose. And I was wondering, where can you get that rose and also the double fly?
Okay. Those should be available at almost any independent garden center. Anywhere you would be familiar with, any independent garden center in any city.
And you sell to the public
as well. Yes, and we sell to the public as well.
And then on the emails at the end of the program, you can always email me and I'll give you his information.
Yes, that's great.
That's great. Located in Central
Yeah, it's Florida. Not hard to find. I mean, sometimes it is hard to find McCartney because it's such a great grower and seller, and double life is kind of hard to grow.
And it's supposed to be a modern rose, yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, it's a modern rose.
Which are bigger.
Yes. Yeah, so you know, I mean, the way I like to put it about modern roses versus old garden roses is all these modern roses came from the old garden roses.
Right.
I mean, they all started out years ago when they started hybridizing these. They were right from the old garden roses.
They come from good genes.
That's why they're still around.
Now, you have a lot of different varieties in front of us. I want you to name them and tell me a little bit about them. Like, there's a pink one up front that's blushed. What's the one up front?
That's California Dreamin'. California Dreamin'. This next one is a Pink Drift, a Drift series of roses from the people that brought us Knockout.
Why is it called a Drift?
It supposedly stays a little shorter and blooms a lot, and it sort of is a carpet rose.
Okay.
They had to come up with a name different than carpet, so they called it a drift rose.
Oh, a drift rose. Okay. Now, this, the pH of all of this, we can't go too close to the beach on any of these.
No, I think you can go to the beach. Anybody that has hibiscus in their yard can grow roses.
Oh, is that right?
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, well, hibiscus they
is, hibiscus is so much more salt sensitive than roses.
Yeah.
Roses are like a weed on our rootstock. That's just the bottom line, they are.
But there's some swamp mallow that is really salt tolerant. You think roses would also survive on
I know. Well, I mean, you know, they're going to take a splash. I mean, if you can grow grass in your yard, you can grow roses.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just simple as that. If you can grow grass and you grow hibiscus, you can grow roses.
You know, roses make great holiday gifts, too. So I want people to think outside the box and think about getting roses for those holiday gifts coming up.
Yeah, well, roses are the only shrub. We have lots of shrubs to choose from in Florida. We have lots of them that bloom. It's just the only one that blooms and has fragrance all year round.
Yeah.
I mean, gardenias are really pretty when they smell really nice, but they don't put out the blooms like roses do.
Is there a time of year or a month in Central Florida or even North Florida where roses are like the best, the ultimate peak? Like spring, summer, winter, fall.
Yeah,
when
it is exactly when everybody wants to carry roses, which is Easter Mother's Day.
Oh, okay.
Easter Mother's Day is exactly everybody wants to get a rose for their mother at Mother's Day, and yes, that's exactly, and it's pretty nice then.
Good. Okay, well, we've got Jim from Orlando on the line. Hi, Jim. Welcome to the program. What's your question?
How you doing? I have a question as far as roses in sun. Are there some that grow better in sun or in shade or partial shade? Are there different varieties for that?
Yes, there are different varieties for growing in that. Mostly roses like at least 6 hours sunlight.
Is that morning or
afternoon?
Pretty
much direct. And morning would be better than afternoon, okay. But at least 6 hours and they're fine. When somebody tries to tell you that their roses will grow in the shade, they're trying to sell you a rose.
Okay.
They're really not, you kind of have to make a choice. You've either got a real pretty yard and you've got azaleas underneath your oak trees and you really don't have roses underneath the oak trees.
Okay. Now, you have this beautiful orange rose up here in front. I don't know if the camera can get that. It's this burnt orange look. What is the variety of that one? That's stunning.
That is a perfect moment.
Perfect moment. Who names these roses?
Oh, the hybridizers name the roses.
Oh, okay. Gosh. Wow. Okay, now you also have the yellow one over on the right. I'm making the camera work
tonight. Yes, this is Julia Childs. We're going to slip into the cooking show. This is Julia Childs.
Okay, and was that named for her many years ago?
Yes, about 10 years ago.
Oh, okay.
10 years ago. She picked it out, and that's how they do that. They have the star come pick the rose out.
Oh.
That's who picked out Cary Grant. Which is called Cary Grant. That's the only person who didn't pick their rose out was probably Mr. Lincoln.
Okay.
Mr. Lincoln wasn't around when they did his rose.
And I know there's one for Lady Diana and all
right,
those.
That's right.
Wow.
Yes.
Where is most of the hybridizing done in the nation?
Pretty much in California.
Okay.
And also in Holland and in Germany and in France.
Okay. Do we do any in Florida?
I don't know if anybody does a whole lot of hybridizing anymore in Florida. I mean, you have people like me that might recognize a sport, and the sport being the BP Nelson is a sport.
Did you name this one?
Yes, I did.
Oh, what's BP named after somebody?
That is my father.
Oh, wow. Okay, now how did you come about with this one?
That is a cross between a double delight and a knockout in some manner. So it's got a lot of the great properties of a knockout rose, it's just way prettier.
Wow, it is. It's
for the women in the audience. You know, it's for the women in the audience. It's men like knockout because it's red. I mean, there's no doubt. Men like red, men like yellow.
Yeah.
If we came up with a yellow knockout, they'd be real successful too.
Wow. Oh, we're still working on that. Well, Patty from Brevard's on the phone. Hi, Patty. Real quick, what's your question for Mark?
There is a little antique rose that I seen when I was a child on a 3-foot fence. They're very tiny. They look like they're an antique. And this Titusville refurbished an antique house. And they have them on their fence post, you know, along their fence. But nobody's ever there. And I'd like to know what in the world the name of them are.
Okay, all right. I'm pretty sure that probably is Louis Philippe.
Okay.
And Louis Philippe is also commonly called the Florida Cracker Rose. And the reason why, because it was around when people were still crackers in the state of Florida.
Wow. Well, and if she has any questions, she can also photograph it and email us, and then I can forward it to you to help identify it.
Yeah, we know exactly what it is, because it's either one of two things. It's probably Old Blush if it's not Louis Philippe. If it's pink, it's Old Blush. If it's red, it's Louis Philippe.
And we've got another caller on the line. Hi, caller. Welcome to the program. What's your question today?
Yes. This is Jean from Winter Garden, and I'm calling with my husband, Cliff, and we wanted to wish Mr. Nelson a happy birthday on Friday.
Oh! Oh, happy birthday, Mark. Oh, it's a celebration. You're getting older.
I'm 50. Thank you very much. I appreciate that, Jean.
What a surprise. Gee, we need calls more like that often.
Yes, we do. That's how we get me.
What a great celebration. What a way to celebrate it. It's a big milestone.
All right.
We've got another caller on the line real quick. Hi, caller. Oh, no more callers. Okay, go ahead and finish real quick.
This is probably the biggest thing going.
Okay, what is it?
In new roses. It's Pope John Paul.
Wow.
Easy care, very fragrant, and very white.
Oh, it is.
It's just a gorgeous rose. I mean, it has a great growth habit, real hardy variety in Florida. Named after a great pope, so it's just a great, you know. Every now and then they name a rose, and it doesn't matter what they named it or what it was, but it's a great variety, and this is just one of those.
Wow! So these are must-haves to have.
They're
our
must
landscape.
Have. They're must-have. Absolutely.
Wow.
Absolutely. Everybody that's ever bought a white rose, they come by John F. Kennedy. They might even buy
and
white.
And that's a white one too.
That's a white one. They might buy John F. Kennedy. He didn't pick his rose out either.
Oh, okay.
Pope John Paul's just super. As you can see, it's just got lots of petals and very fragrant and just a winner.
And it's big.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Yeah, and then you know what I tell everybody to do? Also, mix together different colors. White looks more spectacular when it's contrasted with other different colors.
Absolutely. I've actually had ladies tell me that come by the nursery and I'll cut them a bucket of roses for a function.
Wow.
And they will tell me that they want to match it with the color of their wallpaper.
Yep, and it works every time.
Works every time.
Well, that's all the time that we have, and I hope we've helped answer some of your questions. And I'd like to thank my special guest, Mark Nelson, and thank all of you for joining in the program with your questions on roses. You can always email us at wdsc@daytonastate.edu or friend us on Facebook. Thank you for joining us again on another season of Gardeners Hotline.